Hi guys, welcome to AppSense Pro, welcome to another Shopify how-to video. So last month I created a video related to transparent header, which was working on Dawn 13.0.1. But after that, Shopify released latest version of Dawn, which is 14.0.0. If you want to learn what are the latest features they added, I have created a separate video for that. Link you will find in the description where you can see what are the latest feature they added in Dawn 14.0.0. As you can see on my screen, I have this transparent header showing up on my development store, and when you hover over it, it adds a background. And on scroll down, it's sticky. And as a lot of comments which we received related to the mobile version, so we have disabled that completely on the mobile version, so it's not going to affect your mobile version at all. So the transparent header will work completely fine on the desktop version, and it's not going to affect your mobile version. And also it's not going to affect the inner pages. So in the last version, I added a feature where you could enable and disable it on inner pages, but a lot of the comments which we got was against that feature, and they said that they want transparent header only on the home page and they wanted to have the hover feature. So we added that feature. So what you can do with this tutorial is that you can add the transparent header and you can change the color of the menu item from here. So if I just change the color, add the name of the color, it will change the color name. You can also add hexadecimal hexacode, hex color code for that. So if I just add white color hex code, it's going to change it to white. And if I change it back to gray color, it's closer to white. I think let's try black color. So you can change it to black. I mean, whatever your color you want to add for the menu text and the icons showing up here, you can mention it here and it will update the color. Also, if you want to change the hover background color, so if you want to change the hover background color to white, you can do that. And you can also mention what is the hover text color you want. So let's change it to red and see how it looks. So as you can see, the hover background color and hover text color is working from the settings here, which you can change. So let's revert it back. Okay, let's add white color to my transparent header. Okay, so the font colors are now white and the icon colors are now white, and when I hover over, it adds a gray color background. And now check it on different positioning of the logo. So if you have middle left, it will look like this. Let's move it to top left. Let's change it to top left, and that's how it's gonna look. Let's change it to top center. Let's check the middle center. Cool, it's working fine on all of the positions, all of the desktop logo position. And you can have two separate logos. So one is for the transparent version and one is for the default version when you scroll down. And how you can change that, so if you click on theme settings and go to logo, you have this option here. So that's the default logo, and that's the additional logo which we added from the code. So I'm going to show you guys how you can do that really easily in just two simple steps. All you have to do is just watch the video and implement that on your own without needing for a developer or without needing to pay anything. It's a free tutorial. All you have to do is just follow this video, subscribe to this channel so you can learn more, because I keep creating these videos for you guys, and I just want for you guys to subscribe this channel so I can create more valuable content for you guys. Okay, so without further ado, let's start implementing the transparent header on the fresh Dawn theme. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to the dashboard. So let's navigate back to /admin. And that's the dashboard of my development store. I'm going to click on online store. And that's how it's going to look. Now scroll down. And I'm going to install a fresh Dawn theme. So this tutorial is going to work on a fresh Dawn theme. If you have added any customization previously, it might not work. So it's good to have a backup of your theme. So make sure if you're working on a live theme is to create a duplicate and have a backup. In case you mess up anything, you can easily revert your theme back. Okay, now let's click on add button and install a fresh Dawn theme. While this is installing, guys, I want to show you guys that I also have created a tutorial for how to add video on autoplay. So if you want to have a video on your homepage of your Shopify store, which will be automatically be played on loop. So currently in Shopify, by default, this feature is not available. But if you want to add a video as a featured, which will be continuously playing on loop, you can check out the link in the description, which I have created. Also, I have some other tutorials like this fancy looking badge, which has replaced the text from sale to the discount which you're offering. So it's 22% off, limited time offer. You are unable to change this text using the default Shopify settings, but I have created a tutorial for you guys, which is also free of cost, link in the description. Also, if you want to add color swatches to your product page, which is really very important, Shopify have a ton of paid apps, but if you want to add Shopify product page color swatches for free, check the link in the description below. Okay, let's head back to our themes. And our Dawn 14.0.0 has been installed. Now I'm going to click on publish. Click on publish again. And now let's preview our Dawn 14.0.0. Click on these three small dots and then click on preview. I'm going to close this tab here. And that's how my Shopify Dawn 14.0.0 looks like. And that's how the header looks like. So let's go to themes. And then click on three small dots and then click on edit code. I'm hoping that you already have a backup of your theme code. Now that's the tutorial which you'll be following. Link will be in the description. All you have to do is just follow these two steps. So step one is to replace the header.liquid code. And the step two is to add a little schema to add the transparent header feature. Okay, now click on copy code. And then I'm going to search for header.liquid file. And then I'm going to replace the code. So let's first delete the currently existing code from header.liquid. Copy the code from here by clicking on this copy code button and paste the code. Perfect. After pasting the code, hit save. And now let's move on to the next step. So this is the next step where we will find for settings underscore schema file. And below this mentioned code, we will add the following code. Okay, now let's first search the settings underscore schema. So that's the file. Click on that, settings underscore schema. And now I'm going to search this code here. Copy this code. So that's the code. And after this comma here, add a line break. Copy this code by clicking on copy code button here. And then paste the code. After pasting the code, hit save. Okay guys, now let's click on these three small dots and then go to our customizer by clicking on customize theme. And from there, first what I'm going to do, I'm going to add the logos. So click on this gear icon and then click on logo. And here we have option to add two logos, right? One is the default logo and the other one is the transparent logo, which we added through our schema settings. Okay, now click on select image. And I already have uploaded the logos. Okay, so that's the default version and that's the white version, which I want to display on the transparent header. So let's add the default version here. And now select the transparent one. So here's the transparent one, select that. Perfect. After selecting the logos, click on save. And now click this icon here, the sections. And from here, click on header. And here we have the option to enable and disable transparent header. Now I'm going to enable the transparent header. Perfect. My transparent header logo is showing up. And the text is currently black and I want to display as white. So I'm just going to type white. And here we have our font color changed, the menu font and the icons here, everything is changed. And I also want the hover background color to be gray. So a little light gray when someone hover over it. Okay, looks cool. And in hover transparent color, I like the white, but you can change it if you want, depend on your theme color scheme and depend on your logo color scheme. You can change it to whatever you want. Let me show you how we can change it. So let's change it to red just to show you guys. And now if I hover over, you can see the menu color and the icon color has been changed. Cool. I wanted to leave it as it is. So I'm going to select it as transparent by removing the value of the color. Perfect. Now click on save. Let's select it to be white. Click on save. And now let's preview it on our theme. Looks good. Now if I scroll down, you can see it's changing it to the default logo which we have. And if we go to any of the inner page, it's still the default version. Now my logo is a little small, so I'm going to increase the width of that. So let's go back to the settings of the logo by clicking on this gear icon, and here we have logo settings. Scroll down and increase the desktop logo width to be 170. I think 130 is fine. Yes, that looks good. Okay, now click on save. And now let's go back and hit refresh. Perfect. The logo is looking a bit better with the increased width. And let's check out our submenu. That works fine because we haven't changed anything in the submenu. And if we go to the mobile version, it's not affected at all to your mobile version. Looks good, right? Okay guys, so that's it for the tutorial. If you guys liked it, let me know in the comment below and let me know what more you would like to learn. Until next video, have a great day.